Hey everybody, coming to you from sunny Hawaii today. Decided that we would take the show on the road a little bit, as you can see by the Hawaiian shirt and the backdrop behind me. It just seemed like a nice day to take a trip and do this video from there. Alright, well, it's obviously April 1st, and that is the best I could come up with for an April Fool's joke. But hey, I thought I would do something with you today. I kind of went online and looked at some of the various April Fool's jokes that have been done throughout history, and there's some good ones. I just want to highlight a few of them for a reason. I'll tell you in a second. One of the things I was looking at actually is rated as the number one April Fool's joke of all time. Happened in 1957. The British Broadcasting Corporation actually told people that Italy had a huge crop of spaghetti noodles this year that had grown in their trees, and they took a videographer and they videoed people picking spaghetti noodles out of the tree, and it must have been so convincing that there was actually people in England, in Britain, that decided that they wanted to figure out how to order spaghetti trees, and they attempted to order them. That wasn't all the British Broadcasting Company did. They one other time they told everybody that they were converting Big Ben, the clock, to a digital clock, and they were going to be selling off the arms to the highest bidder. Well, as funny as that is to you and I, apparently it wasn't very funny to the people there, and some people got very upset about it when they found out they couldn't buy the arms to Big Ben, and the BBC ended up having to issue an apology. A little closer to home and closer to today, 1988, Burger King advertised that they were going to be offering a left-handed Whopper. And what they told people was, we actually are putting the condiments on it and swirling them the opposite way to make it easier for left-handed people to hold on to it and eat it correctly. Well, as silly as it sounds, thousands of people showed up to Burger King on April 1st looking to buy a left-handed Whopper. This one might be a little closer to home. Cottonelle, I believe it was 2015, they put out a tweet that said that they were going to be selling left-handed toilet paper to make it a little bit easier for their left-handed purchasers to be able to, well, do what you do with toilet paper. I don't know if a lot of people bid on that, but when Johnny Carson at one time read an article regarding a potential shortage of toilet paper in the country, he kind of made a few jokes about it, but it caused people, at least in Brooklyn, to go out and make a mad rush, and stores began to run out of toilet paper. I know that one probably hits a little bit close to home, doesn't it? Because I was at BJ's yesterday, and guess what? They still don't have any, but that's a different story. 1996, Taco Bell put out a thing on April 1st that said, hey, we have purchased Big Ben as a way of being able to help the United States pay down the national debt. Well, honestly, some politicians and senators and other people believed it, so much so to the point that the National Park Service had to hold a meeting and actually invite the media and share with the media that it was just a hoax. It really wasn't true. A little older, in 1700s in London area, a couple of the bigwigs in London decided that they wanted to see, and one of them, they kind of had a bet with each other and said, hey, I think there's enough fools in London that we could actually say the absolute most crazy thing and convince people it's true. So he did. They actually put an article in the paper and said, hey, on such and such a date, I'm going to get into a bottle, a wine bottle, and you'll be able to see me and hear me singing from that wine bottle. Come to the theater. I'll be in that bottle. You'll be able to pick the bottle up in your hand and shake it and look at me and know that it's really me inside that bottle and singing. And they sold out the theater that day with people who showed up, and actually, unfortunately, when nobody was there with a bottle, the people realized it was a hoax and started a riot. But they were convinced April 1st of that. One last one I thought was really, really interesting. In the year 1708, also in London, there was an astrologer, or a psychic, if you will, and his name was John Partridge. And John Partridge had been using the almanacs and writing articles in the almanacs and telling people of upcoming things and predicting things. And it was obviously a hoax. It was psychic baloney. But he told them that in 1708 in London, there was going to be a huge fever. And it was going to go around. Well, sick of that, a guy by the name of Jonathan Swift decided to write his own little article. And what he did is he said on March 29th, Partridge is going to end up dying of a great fever. Well, Partridge took exception to that, but the people in the community thought that that was quite an intriguing little deal going on. But Partridge decided to write a rebuttal to that, saying it's not true and it's all a lie. But what happened was, on March 29th, Swift actually published a message that said that Partridge had died. But before he died, Swift, according to his article, said Partridge admitted that everything he's been doing all the time has been a hoax. Well, imagine people's surprise on April 1st when they saw Partridge walking around the streets of London. And they were quite surprised. But here's the amazing part about that. So because Partridge wrote another article and said it was all a lie and this guy's a jerk and it's just not true. But what happened was Jonathan Swift wrote another article and says, no, it was true. And any article you're seeing any more from this guy is actually written by somebody else. It's a complete hoax. And you know what happened? Totally ruined that man's career, which I don't know if I would call it a career as a psychic anyhow, but it actually took away his credibility from that point on. Amazing what people will believe on April 1st. But let me tell you this. There's one other thing that is more devastating, and it happens every day of the year, and it can also be just as much of a hoax as an April 1st Fool's Day joke. You know what that is? Opinions. Opinions. Opinions happen every day of the year, and right now we live in this time and age when it's hard to know if opinions are true or not. Listen to one Bible verse, Proverbs 18:2 says this, fools find no pleasure in understanding, but delight in airing their own opinions. And again, we live in a time when opinions are everywhere, and it's getting to the point where it's hard to know what opinions are really true and what opinions are not true. Let me encourage you with this kind of a thought. I know there's a lot of opinions out there, and actually when you go on social media and you scroll through and you look, and we spend a lot of time doing that right now, you're going to see a whole lot of opinions. How do we counteract those opinions when we recognize they could be just as valueless as an April Fool's joke? Well, here's the true answer to this. You need to do something. You need to spend as much time scrolling through truths as you do scrolling through opinions. And the best place to find truths is in the Word of God. My encouragement to you today from all this is this. Spend as much time digging in truths, especially the Word of God, as you spend scrolling through opinions in other places. I hope you'll do that. Take care.